Oh, you finally arrived. We can actually begin now. Yeah, I wasn't too sure if you knew what the meeting point meant. But I'm glad you did. I believe this is where you and I first met, isn't it? Yeah, that's what I thought. Alright, so we are planning a raid today. Make sure you keep your voice down. You wouldn't want them to know we're here. Alright, so I'm gonna get my sketchbook out. So, basically what I'm gonna do is just draw out the plans of what we're gonna do when we get there. So that way you know exactly what to do, when to do it, and we will make no mistakes. Alright, give me one moment while I draw this out for you. So, I don't know if you can see that, I had to write it with purple marker because I only had medjool berries when I was creating the marker, so it might be a little bit hard to see, but you can see right here, that's just kind of like a plateau mountain. They're located right on that mountain, and all of that back there is just forest stuff, just give you an idea, and anything down here is water. So basically what we're gonna do is, let me draw it out for you real quick again. Alright, so we're gonna take some horses in there, we're gonna build around them so they're invulnerable to the turrets. The turret will not be able to shoot them. Supposed to represent the Paraceratheum that we're going to take in, and we're going to build on it, all around it. We're going to put turrets on it, make it our own personal tank, And we're going to use that to get in the base. We're going to infiltrate the base like a Trojan horse almost, except it won't be a trick. It's just going to be, we'll go in and we kill everything. Yes, normally I'm known for stealthy raids, but today we're going to try something a little bit different. So the base I drew on top of the mountain there just looks like it's not very well defended, but I can tell you, there's many things up there, and we can't really get past them stealthily because the turrets will see us and kill us. There's no way to get around that. So, we go in with the horse. Once we get in, we raid everything. And let me show you the supplies we have right now. So, pretty much, what you're going to want to do is, before you even go in, you're going to want to harvest a whole bunch of narco berries, and hopefully, when we go in and raid, if we need to, we can steal some meat off of their animals. Of course, you know, they're going to have a whole bunch of spoiled meat on them, so that way, we can make narcotics if we have to. Narcotics are very important for these type of raids because, you know, say we knock out someone while we're raiding, we can keep them asleep while we raid their base. Killing them wouldn't be a good idea because then they can just easily respawn and then come get you again. You know, they'll be naked, but so they won't have any weapons, but they're more a threat alive than they are asleep, no matter what they have. If their melee damage is like way high, they might just be able to get you in one shot. Suppressed shocking tranquilizer dart weapon. Mine is actually ascendant. I believe I got my ascendant blueprint from the lava golem cave, but I only really have weaker ones for everyone else. I'm gonna probably end up giving you an apprentice, which isn't too bad, but definitely not ascendant. typically you can take out your enemy in about 1 to 2 shots with an ascendant if you place a well shot, a good shot on the head. Then yeah, they're gonna go out in one. Actually, sometimes you can accidentally kill them, but I don't think that will matter. Last time I showed you this, I explained to you the Paracerithium. So, once we get in using the horse, we are going to then raid the base using our weapons, like that tranquilizing gun I just showed you. Then, for the escape route, give me one moment and I will draw that out for you as well. So, the whole time while we're raiding the base, we will have submerged Mozas under the water. There, that is a Moza underwater, and we're going to store a few of them underwater while we're raiding the base. So then, once it's time we actually leave, we can make the Mozas come to the surface, and then we can put all of our stuff onto the Mozas, as if you know, obviously your inventory is going to get full, so you might have to actually go from the base to the Moza. Put your stuff in the Moza, and then go back and forth, kind of like that. So, that's definitely a useful thing to have. It's like really perfect, to be honest, because their base is next to the water, and, where the Moza team, right? So it works out perfect. That way we can just kind of go in and out of their base, one fell swoop, and then, you know, they're done for. But anyways, that is all the preparation I think we need to do. So, are you ready or what? Good. Let's do this. On me.